Greetings, fellow Woodlucks. Welcome to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory in a tactical assault playthrough. Now, I've been trying to make the same intro for the past five times, and I've been sitting here for a while trying to think of how to make this intro. For some reason, I've just been stuck. Anyhow, as the name suggests, we will be going in and we'll be playing this playthrough in a more tactical assault playstyle. We do not intend to be stealthy at all. In fact, we want to head through areas just ignoring cameras and all the directives of stealth, whatever they may be. And unless the mission specifies otherwise, we want to eliminate every single person, more like a police operator or a SWAT operator, whatever, in this playthrough. So, yeah, with that being said, let's go ahead and begin the game then. A new game in normal.
Like a Chinese Jiangwei class cruiser with a North Korean destroyer escort. Events in the Yellow Sea took a turn for the worse today when North Korean and Chinese forces blockaded and boarded a Japanese cargo ship. The North Korean government released no official statement, and their ambassador remained out of contact. While at the UN, Chinese Ambassador Long Dan urged the US and her longtime Japanese allies to remain calm, calling the blockades a legitimate response to what the rest of Asia views as a possible remilitarization of Japan.
This blockade is an act of war. The NSC is working on a formal response, and they've ordered the USS Walsh to close at flank speed. The Walsh is the most advanced spy ship in history. My best man will be on board. What do you know? Chinese and North Korean ships working together again.
It's what we expected.
That's a 056 prototype, Chinese.
Exactly.
How are your sea legs?
I haven't lost them.
Good. Because the 056 prototype isn't the only new fish in the pond.
Admiral Toshiro Otomo, head of Japan's newly formed Information Self-Defense Force, had this to say.
This is another distressing attempt by China and North Korea to further depress our faltering economy. The ISDF and Japan appeal to our allies for the military support promised us under the post-war constitution of 1946.
The fact remains that in the eyes of many in Asia, the ISDF itself is a violation of the post-war constitution prohibiting Japan from maintaining a military force capable of striking beyond its borders. In Asia, the memories of Imperial Japan are still fresh.
Punta Blanco Lighthouse, outside Talara, Peru. Bruce Morgenholt has been kidnapped by a Peruvian specialist group known as the People's Voice. Morgenholt's knowledge of dangerous computer algorithms must not fall into the hands of the People's Voice or their leader, Hugo Lacerda. Now, here's the thing. The introductory cinematic sort of suggests that Sam is actually going aboard the cruiser that got hijacked by the Chinese and North Koreans. But when the mission actually begins, we are investigating Morgenholt's disappearance. Now, let me just go ahead and warn you that I will be spoiling the hell out of this playthrough, and I will be giving a perspective wherein you already know everything, or you already know the entire plot, just so that you guys can connect the individual pieces together better. So in that regard, as far as this itself is concerned, it sort of suggests that they may have been planning an additional level before this level ever began, and that is practically how Sam got to, you know, this place in Punta Blanco Lighthouse in Peru, when he set foot aboard the, you know, Chinese cruiser or something, to essentially liberate it and return it to the proper authorities, probably return it to the Japanese civilians, the people who got boarded. Now, the issue is, it probably got cut. Anyhow, let's just go ahead and listen to the briefing, and then I'll begin spoiling the story.
Fisher, an American engineer named Bruce Morgenholt has been kidnapped by a Peruvian separatist group called the People's Voice. Their suspected leader, Hugo Lacerda, is a hardcore revolutionary preaching information warfare as the only realistic means to achieve revolution in modern society. We need you to get in there and recover or destroy any information Morgenholt may have been forced to divulge, and if possible, rescue him. As for Lacerda, he's just been bumped onto our target of opportunity list. So if you have a shot, take it.
Hostage rescue isn't normally our bag, but Morgenholt was part of Project Watson, the UN committee that studied Phillip Masse's handiwork after Georgia. Some people are worried that this kidnapping is just a cover-up, and that Morgenholt is being interrogated for classified information about the Masse Kernels. Fact is that some of the tricks Masse came up with could be used to do a lot of damage. We need to contain that information at all costs.
The target area is a lighthouse attached to an abandoned Spanish colonial-era fortification and some nearby structures. We don't have an exact location on Morgenholt, so you'll have to find him yourself. Insertion will be at night by Zodiac onto the beach beneath the fort. Thermal imaging shows that there are some old natural and semi-natural caves under the fort, so you may be able to use those for infiltration.
All right, Fisher. The helicopter will drop you a few kilometers offshore in the Zodiac. You'll have one of my Zodiacs and logistical support in and out of the target area. Extraction will be by helicopter from the top of the lighthouse.
This place, International, holds the contract with Wright Pritchard Technologies to protect their VIPs in potentially hostile situations. We did a thorough threat evaluation for their project in Peru, and we accepted the VIP detail on Morgenholt. The guys who came after him knew what they were doing. This was not a tourist grab. I lost 3 good men in the snatch, and I'm currently preparing a rescue plan for approval from Morgenholt's family and Wright Pritchard. This is going to cost this place a lot of money.
It probably is. Now, here's the thing. The actual person who's really interested in the Masse Kernels is none other than this guy, Douglas Shetland, Sam's dear friend. Now, he says that he was actually in charge of the VIP protection detail on Morgenholt. However, knowing that this guy is pretty much the one who contracted Lacerda to kidnap and torture the information out of Morgenholt, he essentially conducted the grab himself. There was no other third party. It was displaced. His men grabbed Morgenholt and handed him over to Lacerda. Now, the reason that they handed him over to Lacerda was to provide a layer of security to these guys, so that whatever Lacerda does not blow back onto these guys, and, you know, spy agencies such as the NSA cannot exactly figure out as easily that this was the guy that pretty much handled the whole thing. The next few levels, more or less, are about how Sam figures out, the NSA's third echelon figures out how everything is connected, who's really behind all of this. I think it's not until Hokkaido that we really figure out who's behind it all, and then we have to take a diversion. But anyway, so yeah, this guy kidnapped Morgenholt. That's the spoiler for the section. Now, we will be taking the assault recommendation. There's a full grip attachment, but I don't know whether we get a shotgun or anything. Apparently not in this, not for this playthrough, not for this level at least. Just a full grip attachment, which will enable us to use the sticky cam, a fall round, and a flash grenade. Just these two actually, cameras and a fall rounds for reconnaissance, and in case we need to, you know, stun people for whatever reason. The equipment does matter in this playthrough because we will be using a lot of it. Now, the thing is, since we're playing with normal, we don't really have to bother with, you know, going about and picking up stuff. But if you're playing it on, like, expert mode, I was calling it realistic all these days, but if you're playing it on expert mode, you will actually start out with no ammo whatsoever. You will have to manually go into every single level and pick up ammo as you find it. So that being said, let's go ahead and begin this then. Blue is first person. Can I not? What's going on? Excuse me? Ah, there it is. This game looks so different in first person, I swear. Like, the biggest issue is the fact that you can never really figure out whether your back is stuck to the wall or not. But luckily, if a situation ever occurs where you need to stick your back to the wall in this game, Chaos Theory, it does it for you. You don't need to do it manually.
I'm hearing gunfire down there, Fisher. Everything all right?
It's coming from up ahead, but Lambert, when I think gorilla, I think Kalashnikov.
What do you mean?
I've had enough AKs fired at me in my time to tell you that wasn't one.
All right. See if there's anything unusual going on with their equipment. And keep us posted.
Roger. So I'm using native languages since what the people here are saying doesn't really matter to us. So as you can see, the spread is very tight. When you're using the first person mod, it's hardly swaying the weapon. And the walking speed is very fast. We can actually set it. We can actually set the walking speed.
Our I think own you're self. Right about the equipment, Sam.
Yeah. They got themselves a little stockpile of high-tech kit here.
Try and find out where they got it. See if those crates have SSCC barcodes on them. Scan them with your EEV.
Right, we're done to that side. Let us go ahead and scan the crate then.
SSCC code is lot 1 of 5. See if you can find the other 4.
I'll do my best.
Right then. 21 rounds remaining. Maybe we should reload. Another crate right here.
Next.
Now for this next section, I accidentally shot Morgenholt.
¿No crees que ya es suficiente?
Será suficiente.
He's still alive at this time.
Estoy viendo visiones otra vez.
Vale, debe estar en alguna parte.
Me han dado maldición.
Come on. I'm just holding the angle right now. Look, it's actually pretty difficult to save Morgenholt.
¿No crees que ya es suficiente?
¿Será su...?
¿Había alguien moviéndose por ahí? ¿Quién?
One down. I need to get that guy as well, but I can't find an angle to him. Yep. I don't know whether I got him or not. I don't think I did. Sam is still breathing, but the scope is not swaying as much. We have not shot Morgenholt yet, so he might yet be alive. You know what? Let's go ahead and use the stick camera. Whoops. Maybe there's another guy there.
doesn't sound too good down there, Fisher.
The sound isn't the problem. He should smell it.
You're sure he's dead?
Deader than Elvis.
All right. Leave the body. We still need to recover any traces of the interrogation. Grim, we'll call you back.
Yeah, I tried saving this guy, but we can't really save him. He pretty much dies with the last shock. Here's the thing. If I had just waited about, Morgenholt would be screaming another time, indicating that he was still alive, but we can't really do that right now. We sort of interrupted that. And right now, the only thing we have is the option to free Morgenholt. But the game already counts him as dead, so it's pretty much a scripted event. However, I did realize, discover something new, a new bit of dialogue.
Sam, what are you doing?
Making sure he's not suffering.
Well, leaving NATO rounds in his body is not going to look good. Leave the evidence alone and get moving.
On my way.
All right, then.
Sam, it's Grim. We need to make sure that whatever Morgenholt might have told them about Masse's algorithms never leaves this site.
Okay.
I detected a wireless link coming from the technician who left the room before you entered.
So I'll need to recover any data he might have uploaded to their servers.
Exactly.
From the looks of it, these guerrillas have a pretty temporary setup. Seems unlikely they have any kind of alarm system on location.
Good.
Where's this guy? I thought I saw him right here. What the fuck? It's still strange that you cannot exactly excuse me? Right. This game isn't really meant to be played in the first person. And whenever you try to do that, you'll encounter problems like this. Where you're practically clipping through the walls. Look at this guy right here. Okay, let's go and use it.
Sí, estará fuera un tiempo. ¿Cuántos hombres iban?
Las... ¿Qué ha sido eso?
He oído algo.
Tú siempre estás haciendo cosas.
No, en serio, ahora estoy seguro.
Come here.
Necesito refuerzo.
That did not work out.
That's four of the five crates, Sam. Keep your eyes peeled for the last one.
Absolutely. The movement speed with the weapon drawn has been improved. We'll just go ahead and eliminate you manually. Too bad we couldn't see how that works. I would like a medkit though at this point. It's very difficult to see where you're going for this with this mod on. Is that the guy that I need to eliminate? Yes, yes it is. Done.
That server is the one that the tech transferred the interrogation record to. You'll need to access it. Good work, Sam. That wiped whatever information Morgenholt might have given them.
Don't they wonder what happened to it?
It was easy enough to make your little intrusion look like a memory allocation error. Don't worry, we give you the best tools.
That is true. Pretty short run through the levels. Still through the mods. Final creep.
Good work, Fisher. We can analyze the intelligence you gathered from those crates. We can make a lot of people's jobs a whole lot safer.
That is true.
No one ever does things to make my job safer.
If you want me to hire some more analysts to interpret information for you, I can.
Second thought. The danger's not so bad.
So if you actually shoot this thing, it opens up the zipline for you to use, And you can just practically use the zipline to get all the way there. But you need to kill this guy in the process though. There's literally no other way around it. Alright, zipline time. And we landed right in front of that guy.
Whoa, that was extreme.
Radio man and radio all at once. I figure it was a good investment of resources.
I think he was radioing the smugglers who delivered the arms.
Oh. Oops.
Well, check if they keep a comm log on file somewhere.
Okay, I'll look around here.
And take it easy, Fisher. You were less messy when you were younger.
The bad guys grew up. I had to adapt.
Damn. I mean, even Grim is reprimanding him now. I mean, that's just one of the things I love about Gears 3. Even the dialogue adapts to your playstyle. I'd never heard these dialogues before. Ooh, medkit.
Maria Narcissa.
You're not trying to set me up on another blind date, I hope.
The Maria Narcissa is a boat.
So was the last girl you set me up with.
Fisher.
Sorry.
The Maria Narcissa is a cargo ship, owned and operated by Celestina Inc., Portuguese shipping company. Registered in the Philippines, cross-Pacific freight contracts, lots of details missing.
Sounds suspicious.
Sounds like I'm setting you up for another date after all.
Can't wait to meet her.
Fisher, your primary objectives are complete. Extract you whenever you're ready. You'll need to signal for a helicopter pickup from the top of the lighthouse. Make sure the light is out first.
Will do.
Right then. Okay, let us go ahead and use this to maybe try and blow out the lights, if possible. That's it? Okay. I thought it would be much more difficult, but apparently not.
Sam, from everything we're seeing here, it looks like Lacerda's already flown the coop. Scratch the objective. You don't need to worry about taking him out.
Yeah, you just said that I'm done with all my primaries. Look at him hanging off the railing like that. Okay, yeah, we need to take this out as well. I mean, that's one way to do it. And, I sort of miss this cool section where you can, like, literally track this guy down, but oh well. Alright, time to call for extraction then. And that was that for this mission. I mean, we came in to essentially, you know, save Morgenholt and eliminate Lacerda if possible. However, we sort of failed in doing both of our primary objectives. The only primary objective that we could actually complete is deleting the data that they could have possibly gleaned from Morgenholt's kidnapping, and that's pretty much it. So, yeah. This takes us over to the Maria Narcissa, though. Where, you know, I mean, I sort of forgot to tell you guys that it becomes so much quicker to just eliminate enemies in this game. I mean, I literally blazed through this level in like 11 minutes and 19 seconds. So, but then again, your success rating is going to take a nosedive. You're only going to get like 53% success rating. So, and there are two bodies found apparently, and probably because of the enemies that I had already killed. Anyhow, yeah, that was pretty much that for this level. When we come back, we will be picking up the story from here and heading over to the Maria Narcissa to eliminate Lacerda. So until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.